Armageddon. You've all seen the movie. Bruce Willis and Ben Affleck have to travel through space and land on this giant meteor that's hurling itself towards Earth. And Ben Affleck and Bruce Willis have to drill through the center of this meteor and blow it up and destroy it before it destroys Earth. But that's not what we're talking about today. Hi, I'm Joe Cavasso with Century 21 All Points Real Estate, and I'm here to talk about Armageddon that's currently in the newspapers. I'm sure if you've read any of the media out there, you've seen the following headlines: recession, trade wars, stock sell-offs, and you're wondering to yourself, how does that impact the current real estate market? Well, I'm here today to talk about the last couple recessions, what a recession actually is, and how it's going to impact Connecticut's housing market. So first, let's discuss what is an actual recession. Recession is two consecutive quarters where the U.S. GDP decreases instead of increases or staying stable. It has nothing to do with the housing market. There's been five major recessions since 1980. First, you have the one in 2008, where housing prices really did fall. They fell 19.7%. Then 2001, they actually increased 6.6%. 1991, they fell again, but only 1.9%. In 1981, they increased 3.3%, and then in 1980, they increased 6.1%. So as you could see, a recession doesn't necessarily mean a housing market crash like everybody thinks it does. So let's talk about current market conditions in Connecticut and what we anticipate is going to happen in the next probably 15 to 18 months. Will we see a recession? Probably. I would say there's a pretty good chance that we're going to see an economic recession because of the things that are in the headlines. The trade wars, the stock sell-offs, the fact that stock prices, you know, almost doubled in the last couple years. So, how does that affect our current housing market? First of all, we're not going to see the effect that the rest of the country does because Connecticut hasn't seen the appreciation that California has, that Arizona, Florida, any of the big states that have seen massive increases in their average sale price over the last couple years since really 2010. Connecticut stayed relatively flatlined. Why is that? Well, in 2008, the housing market collapse really revolved around mortgages and the mortgage industry. First of all, you had lots of homeowners refinancing their houses, using them as credit cards, and pulling out massive amounts of equity from their home. Because of that, now they owed much, much more on their house than it was actually worth. How were they allowed to do that? Well, appraisers were really, really generous in what they allowed for home values. Lenders allowed 100% financing, in some cases over 100% financing. Anybody, you didn't even really have to have a job or any documentation showing what you actually made for a living. It was crazy. I remember people buying houses that we knew they would never be able to afford. Once there was some sort of economic correction, now of course they couldn't pay for their house, they got foreclosed on, and the housing market blew up. But what we've seen recently is that lenders are much, much more responsible in their lending practices. Appraisers aren't overvaluing houses. Lenders are requiring stable income, great credit, not great credit, but decent credit, sustainable income to debt ratios. Because of that, the housing market really did stay stable in Connecticut. If you didn't have large down payments, so for instance, if a house appraised for $200,000 and you were trying to buy it for $250,000, unless you have that extra $50,000 cash, which a lot of people in Connecticut did not, then you couldn't buy the house for $250,000. The bank wouldn't just write the check for it. You had to buy it $200,000. So the housing prices stayed stable. They didn't really increase. So because of that, if there is some sort of economic crisis, which I don't think it will be a crisis, now the housing prices don't have all that far to fall anymore. It's still going to be stable. So what does that mean for you? Interest rates are extremely low. They're about 3.25% right now for a 30-year fixed mortgage. That is crazy. When I bought my first house in 2001, interest rates were 7%. Back during about 2008, 9, 10, during the recession, they fell to 5%, and everybody thought that was free money. Recent years, they came down even further into the threes, but last year, they came back up to about 5%. Now we're back down into the low threes. Money is very cheap if you have good credit and good income. So if you're looking at buying a house or upgrading your current house in the next 12 to 15 months, I think this is a great time. Money's cheap, prices are stable, and the economy, I think, is going to be relatively firm. So please, if you have any questions, give me a call, shoot me a message. I'm here to help you. I'll answer any questions that you have, and have a great weekend.